charge from infinity to the point where you are finding the potential. Okay? Written?
1 unit
of charge from infinity to the point where you are finding the potential. Okay? Now, listen here. What I have asked you to write? Work them to move the charge from infinity to that point. So whatever work you do, negative of that work will be done by the electrostatic field. Fine? And negative of that will be potential energy. Because in potential energy at infinity is zero. Fine? So it is one and the same thing, potential energy per unit charge. I am repeating again. Whatever work you do, okay, negative of the work done should be by the electrostatic force, because total work done should be zero. There is no change in kinetic energy. We are slowly moving the charge from infinity to that point. Okay, so work done by you is, negative of work done by you is the work done by the electrostatic force. And negative of the work done by the electrostatic force is the change in potential energy. Change in potential energy is what? Potential energy now minus potential energy at infinity. Potential energy at infinity was zero. So net net, everything boils down to potential energy. Fine? So mathematically straightforward, but if in your school they ask you the definition, you have to write like that, otherwise you will not get marks. Okay? Now potential of a point charge, just like electric field of a point charge, is very simple. Which is what? You know that potential energy between the two charges is K Q1 Q2 by R. So potential of a charge, let's say potential of a charge Q1 at a distance R is K Q1 by R. Understood? This is for the point charge only. Point charge. Okay? This is what? This is the potential of Q1 at a distance R. Any doubt? No doubt? If I tell you potential at a point is V1 and potential at the other point is V2, okay? If I tell you potential at a point is V1 and potential at a point is V2, and you go from point 1 to point 2, how much potential energy is changed? V2 minus V1 is potential difference. Energy is how much? If charge is Q, potential at Q, V2 is Q times V2, and V1 is Q times V1, right? So,
V2 minus V1.
Q times V2 minus V1 is the change in potential energy. Fine? No doubt, right? Now there is a concept of equipotential surface. Equipotential surface is nothing but locus of all the points that has the same potential. Fine? Locus of all the points, write down locus of all the points that has same potential is equipotential surface. Locus of all the points having same potential is equipotential surface. So if you move along the equipotential surface, the work done will be zero. Yes or no? Change in potential energy is zero. V2 is equal to V1, so change in potential energy is zero. Okay? So work done was what? Work done was change in potential energy plus change in kinetic energy. Change in kinetic energy anyway, usually we can keep it zero. So if delta U is zero, work done will also be 0. Fine. So it makes sense to find out the equipotential surface for some basic charge distribution. Okay. For example, let's take a point charge, positive point charge. Write down. For a positive point charge, can you draw equipotential surface? Draw it.
Yeah.
Sir.
It's a sphere around the
circle. Is it sphere?
Yeah. Around the point. Point at the center.
A sphere around the point at the center.
For a point charge, it is concentric spheres. Now all concentric spheres are at a different potentials. Potential of this will be more or this will be more. Let's say this is V3, this is V2, and this is V1. Which potential is highest?
V1
is highest. Okay? So remember, when you move away from the positive charge, potential of the closest point will be highest. Okay? But this entire ring or entire sphere has the same potential. All of you are clear, right? Whatever is. Now it is very easy to draw the electric field lines due to a dipole or due to due to any particular shape and size of the charge. Okay, so if I somehow understand how potential or equipotential surface is placed with respect to electric field lines, so given electric field line, can I plot the equipotential surface? Then it will be easier for me. Okay, so basically I am trying to find out a relation between electric field and potential. Okay, write down a relation between E and V. There is a relation between force and the potential energy. Yes or no? What negative of the work done by the force is change in potential energy. But is there a relation between E and V? There has to be, because force is derived from E and potential is derived from V. Yes or no? So if I go from from point 1 to point 2 and delta V is the change in potential energy will be this. Any doubt? Q delta V. Right? Now, can I find out change in potential energy in terms of electric field? Can I do that?
Yeah.
How? See, Q times E is what? Force. This is force. Right? So, work done will be what? Force dot product with delta R. Okay? So negative of work done should be equal to change in potential energy. This should be equal to minus of Q E dot delta R. Write this down. So Q delta V should be equal to minus of Q E dot delta R. Okay? This is a very, very important relation. Given electric field, you can find the potential. Okay. Now suppose the change is very, very small. If change is very small, I can write like this. dV is equal to minus of magnitude of E into magnitude of, let's say, dr into cos of angle between E and dr. Fine. Now tell me, what is E cos theta? Can I say E cos theta is component of electric field in the direction of dr?
Yes.
Because theta is angle between E and dr. Fine. So I can say that dv is equal to minus of electric field in the direction of r into dr. So from here you get E is equal to minus of dv by dr. Okay. Now here you need to understand that finding a component of field in the direction of r. Okay, so suppose v is a function of different variables. Suppose it is a function of x and y both. Then you have to partially differentiate it. Have you heard of partial differentiation?
Yes, sir.
Where?
Maths.
Maths, you already heard of partial differentiation. Right? So let's see whether you know it properly. Suppose v is given as 2x square plus 3y cube. Can you find out electric field for this using this definition? Find out electric field for this potential field. Partial derivative with respect to r means you are assuming only r is a variable and all of the variables you are treating constant.
Now, can you draw the
equipotential surface for a dipole. Two equal and opposite charges placed in front of each other like this. First you draw the field lines and then draw the equipotential surface. First draw the electric field lines and then perpendicular to that you try to draw the surface. Have you drawn the field lines? The field lines we have already drawn earlier classes. Yes or no?
Yes.
It's a crab. Should be perpendicular to these field lines. Can you try to draw the equipotential surface? Can you draw first equipotential surface, which is very obvious?
Line in the middle.
Yeah. Good. So this is the equipotential surface. Can you tell me what is the potential of this line? Zero. KQ by this distance minus KQ by that distance. Zero. So throughout this line, potential is zero. Draw two more.
Is it like this?
Minus Q.
This is plus Q and this is minus Q. So K plus Q by this distance plus K minus Q by that distance. So it becomes zero.
So then it will be like this.
Put it behind also. Make it complete. All other equipment surface will be closed.
What you have drawn?
Draw a field line, don't forget that. You started drawing some, modern line. What is that? What is this? No, not like that. It can't have two curves. So this is convex as well as concave. Can't be both curvatures. Only one curvature. This is convex. Are you an artist? Okay, see, the thing is, it should be perpendicular, right? So it will be like that, and then this is how it will be. How many of you have drawn like this? How do you check whether you have drawn correct or not? No, that is one thing, but then even mine is not 100% perpendicular. Here, this side should be flatter and that side should bulge out. Okay? See, the lines are between these two charges, lines are like this. So when you have to cut it perpendicular, automatically it becomes flat. Fine? Now, another one. Suppose you have two positive charges. Can you draw the field lines and then the equipotential surface?
Sir, we are.
Sir.
We are well shown.
Yeah.
Drawn the field lines. It will be same.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exact same. No.
Inside. No. Sir, inside it will be bulge. And it will be exact opposite.
Exact opposite or exact same?
Sir, it's, it will be it's like a reflection. Yeah. It will be what? Reflection.
No.
If you have slim two version of that.
Free to say whatever. Free to say whatever. This is what the field line will be. Right? Now, as most of you have correctly understood, the bulge will be inward. The nature of field lines are like that. If you draw perpendicular, the bulge will be inverse and flattened out outside. So one of the curve will be infinity. Throughout this entire thing, potential will be same. Okay? And then you will get curve like this. It will envelop the infinity. How many of you got this? You got the infinity? Infinity was the main thing. I mean, it is like if bulge is inward, they will meet.
The bulges are meeting.
Then see, two bulges are meeting. Okay?
I actually did it.
You all the time say that.
No, I didn't draw it like an infinity, but it looks like.
But you were thinking about
it. No, it looks like
infinity. Your thought is infinite.
Yeah, that's fair.
It encompasses every answer.
Yeah.
Zero.
Anyone got the answer?
We're finding at the center.
Charge per area is given as sigma. enough nonsense now. Okay? I'll ask you to leave. Pay attention. Or don't sit. You don't, you're not required if you think that this is nonsense. Okay? Okay? Final potential over here. Treat entire disk as if it is made up of concentric rings. Use a ready-made formula for the ring and then integrate. The radius will increase. Radius of the ring will increase when you integrate. Another hint is, take a radius R ring whose width is dr. Like this. Okay, R, small r is the radius and dr is the width. Try to do it yourself. Get the potential of this ring and then integrate small r from 0 to capital R. Capital R is the radius of the bigger this thing, of the disk. Since 4-hour class is there, so last 45 minutes we can have a small test. Or last 1 hour, 45 minutes to write a test, and last 15 minutes I'll discuss the test with you. Whatever we do on that day, I'll write down few questions, take it like a test, and we'll discuss with them. Okay? That way, those who want to just attend for 3 hours, they don't miss anything. And those who want to test themselves, I can write out questions and we can discuss it. Because ultimately, when you struggle to solve a question, then only you learn. Okay? Doesn't matter how many problems I solve on the board. It's when you struggle. Okay, now tell me, what is the potential due to this ring of radius small r and width dr? How much is the charge on it? dq is what? Sigma into?
2 pi r.
2 pi r dr. Sigma is charge per unit area. You have to multiply that with area of the ring. The width of the ring is dr. This is dq. And potential due to the ring was what? K times dq divided by root over r square plus z square. Isn't it? Right? So now I will substitute the value of dq, which is k sigma 2 pi r dr divided by root over r square plus z square. This is my dv in terms of r. Okay? Total potential will be what? Integral of this. Okay? So when you integrate, you get the total potential. The limits will be from 0 to capital R. So sigma into 2 pi into k comes out. Sigma into pi k you just take outside. You get 0 to r, 2r dr divided by root over r square plus z square. Okay? Now if you assume r square plus z square as t, we'll get 2r dr as dt. You know how to solve that integral, right? Integral is not yet done in mathematics. Okay, so it will be. So that is why I was hesitant to do this today. Anyways, let's solve it. Sigma into pi, k is what? 4 pi epsilon naught. Now, this you have assumed to be t. So when r is equal to 0, t is equal to z square. So this is z square. And when r is equal to capital R, it will be r square plus z square. Okay? So this is dt divided by root over t. Pi and pi gone. So you will get sigma by 4 epsilon naught. T raised to power minus half, right? Integral of T raised to power minus half dt is what? This will be T raised to power minus half plus 1 divided by minus half plus 1. Okay? So I will get 2 root T. Limits will be from z square to z square plus r square. So you will get sigma by 2 epsilon naught under root z square plus r square minus z. Okay, that is the potential due to the disk. Understood? So if I keep a small charge q over here, what will be the potential energy between this and that? If I keep a small q at a distance z from the disk, what will be the potential energy? That into this. Simple. Understood? Right? You can see that when you are putting z equal to 0 over here, the formula changes to sigma r by 2 epsilon naught. So at the center will be when z equal to 0. Fine. This actually formula is required because in your CET also, in CET, JEE Mains and everywhere, you know, at least up to this, they expect you to know. That is why I got this. Okay. Right on. Potential. Potential is constant. Okay? So how much is that? You don't need any calculus, nothing. Just apply some logic, you'll get the answer.
Now let's try to find out potential
Till where this chapter is done in school? First chapter, half.
So there are two classes, so it's
I think the school will resume only after your summer vacations.
This Monday,
but then when is summer vacation starting?
Next week Friday.
Okay. So, and then two weeks of summer vacation.
Two months.
So much study you can do, na? 2 months.
29th.
2 months. 2 months is like
the new diary told you it's 6th June.
No.
How many of you are going to celebrate the summer vacation?
A bit.
Nobody is going to outside. Do you have Australia?
Mumbai. Sir, we go out, come here. Sir, in the holidays when send them
all. See, you can study also. So you have like 2 months, as in 8 classes of physics. 8 classes of physics will be, this chapter will get over by mid of next session, next class of physics will be done. And then after that we have 8 more classes. So we can complete 4 or 5 more chapters. Okay? And then just 8 or 9 more sessions are required to complete your 12 syllabus. 12 syllabus is very less. And then we can revise 11th. Revise as in just revisit. Okay? So, fine. And since ray optics is also not there, when ray optics was there, we were finishing the syllabus by mid of October. Now if ray optics is not there, we can finish by mid of October or maybe starting of October. So this is what? April is starting. April, May, June, July, August. Oh, 6 or 7 months. It's long to go. Anyways, let's do this potential due to a dipole. And let me tell you again that these two chapters are considered to be the most difficult. So do this properly so that you don't have headache of coming back to this chapter again and again. Once you do these two chapters, systematically work hard these two chapters, rest everything in physics becomes very, very straightforward. Okay? And in order to understand what kind of problem and variety, you need to first do the homework, right? And then solve at least 100 more questions. And then only you will get an idea. Don't just understand, okay, nothing but force it there. Potential is there, potential energy is there. Unless until you solve a lot of questions, you will not understand what kind of varieties are there. Okay? Fine, so let's talk about the potential due to dipole. This is plus charge, this is minus charge, suppose. This is a dipole vector from negative to positive, yes or no? Tell me what is the potential along this line, bisector? Along this line. Potential is 0. Right? So when we deal with potential, we are not finding potential at special points like axial line and equatorial plane. But when we are dealing with electric field, we found only about axial and about equatorial. But since potential is a scalar, we have to just add them like numbers. We can find potential at any random location. Okay? So I try to find out potential over here. Okay? This, how you locate this point? You connect a line like this. This line makes angle theta and the distance is r. Fine? So theta and r is enough for this point P to be uniquely determined. Okay, this is a midpoint. Okay, you have to find out potential at P because of these plus and minus charge. Alright, let me make a small construction. This distance, let us say, is r plus, and that distance is, let's say, r minus. So what should be the potential at point P in terms of r plus and r minus? Tell me. Potential due to this charge will be what at that point?
KQ by R.
R plus is the distance, na? This charge is the distance of R plus. So KQ by R plus, then for this it will be minus KQ by R minus. So minus of KQ by R minus, a negative charge. So this will be KQ 1 by R plus minus 1 by R minus. Okay? But R plus and R minus are not given. What is given is this distance is A from here to here. This is A and that distance is also A. And this is theta.